Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss one more interview question, and mostly you asking an interview, which is cache and persistence is a kind of transformation or action, something like. So such kind of different questions they will ask. So in this video we are going to see that in detail and will give some tips how to validate whether it is a transformation or action. Let's go and see that. Let me see that simple trick to find that method is a kind of transformations or actions. Whenever you're going to call that method, you just collect the return data type using type functions in Python. If that return data type comes with any one of Spark Core API like a data frame or DD, then it is a part of transformations. If it is returns non-Spark Core API like list, tuple, something, then we can consider that is an action. Because each transformations will create a new data frames. But actions is always calling at lost. So once action is passed, automatically DAG will create and each action will be following that particular DAG and complete the task. Let me see first how cache is working. Whenever you're going to call your data frame or RDD or data set that have internally multiple partitions. While calling cache method, all the data will be split based on the partition and working with multiple nodes. And each node that will be serialize the data and store this heap values in memory. So that is the reason whenever you're going to call any action, immediately the data will be retrieved from the particular data frame or RDD and providing you much faster. Let me see about persist now. Same like caches, if suppose you're going to use the persist of storage level, here for the example I'm taking memory and disk. While you're going to call this method, same like as caches, all the data will be split and executed via partitions with multiple nodes. But it's trying to persist all the data that cache output into memory. But unfortunately, the memory is not capable to store all your data. And then it is trying to store that information into disk. So whenever you're going to call the particular data frames or RDD numbers, that is going to be inferred from this disk and giving you. To compare with cache, persist is little slow whenever it's going to store the data into disk format. But if it is trying to store everything in the memory, cache and persistence is more or equal. Now let me solve this interview questions with some examples. Here I just developed some codes. In line number 19, I just create a data frame with the caches. This cache transformation, once it is executed, and I'm just going to be referred based on type functions. This type function only generated with the Spark Core API like pyspark.sql.dataframes. From this we can consider this is a kind of transformations. Now we can apply persist method. I am just using data frame 5 on top of data frame 3 with persist of storage level of memory and disk. And I just going to see the return data type for the persist of data frame 5. And it is producing the output for PySpark Core API only. So from there we can consider this is also kind of transformations. Now you are able to understand how to find that particular method is a kind of transformation or action from this video. Thanks to watching this video, please provide your valuable feedbacks in comments.